Did you guys know that it's World Turtle Day? I used to have a turtle. His name was Bradley. Yeah. Throw that turtle emoji in the chat. Aren't they so cute? Anyways, let me ask you this. Which turtle video should we play? The I Like Turtles Kid, Turtle Fail, or Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles? Tap on what you want to see, baby. Yeah, yeah. Get your tap on. Get your tap on. All right now. What's it gonna be? All right. 40% of you want to see Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Hit it. Oh man, I watched that movie until I broke the VCR in the living room. That's crazy. You know what? I want to see the Turtles Kid. Let's see the Turtles
Jonathan,
Kid.
Jonathan, you're looking good. Jonathan just got an awesome face paint job. What do you think?
I like turtles.
All right, you're great zombie.
He liked turtles. Okay, we'll do the last one. Come on. What is it? What's he doing up there? No! No, turtle, no! Oh, dang. Oh. I give him a 4. That was a terrible dive. I give him a 4. It's game time. Alright, babies, nothing to it but to HQ it. Let's get it cracking with question number 1. Arnold Schwarzenegger appears in a brand new trailer for an upcoming film in what series? Terminator, Systems Administrator, or Procrastinator? Yeah, come on, stop the answer. Pick it. Hurry up. Do it. Yeah. Every time there's an Arnold question, I have to do that voice. One Terminator isn't cool. You know what is cool? A whole bunch of Terminators. In the upcoming Terminator Dark Fate. Yes, 250,374 are ready for some more. Let's go to work. Come on with it, babies. Question number 2. Oh, hey, if you want to multiply your points even more during the game, you can purchase a points multiplier. Get one right now if you see it on your screen. Start this season off strong, babies. For sure. Let's go. All right. Now it's time for question 2. Y'all ready? I'm ready. Whoop-de-doo. Question 2. Which of these is found inside a traditional Reuben sandwich? Lettuce, tomato, or sauerkraut? This is making me hungry. Why we got to have a food question so early? Early in the game. I'm hungry. All right, a Reuben sandwich is typically corned beef, Swiss cheese, and sauerkraut. And Russian dressing on rye. Sauerkraut is the rye answer. 247,322 knew what to do. Yeah. All right. Question number 3. Take a look at me. Here we go. Y'all ready? Finish the lyric. In New York, concrete jungle where dreams are made of, there's nothing what you can't do but blue skies, or I won't try. It took everything in me not to finish singing. That song is such a, whew, dare I say, it's almost as catchy as question 5. I dare. All right, the Empire State of Mind lyric is there's nothing you can't do. Concrete jungle where dreams are made. 197,329 got it. Okay, and 27,000 thought it was but blue skies. No, silly. No. All right. Question number 4, knocking on your door. N represents the chemical symbol for what? Nickel, neon, or nitrogen? What's it gonna be? All these elements. All starting with N. So who's gonna get the N? It's the chat's favorite element, nitrogen. Nitrogen, babies. 183,802. Oh, yeah. That's right. Don't forget, question 9 is coming up. That's when you're going to have an opportunity to take home some money. All right? So let's get to it. Question 5. Question 5. Question five. Here we go. Which of these movie franchises has not released the same number of titles as the other two? Fast and Furious, Mission Impossible, or Rocky? Fast and the Furious, Mission Impossible, or Rocky? All right. The Rocky and the Fast and the Furious franchises have both released 8 titles, although that statement is only going to stay true until August. The last Mission Impossible to come out was the 6th one. Mission Impossible is the answer there. Oh boy, that's a savage question. Here we go, savage question song. Sorry you got it wrong. Savage question song. That's a savage question song. Mission Impossible. Mission Impossible. Okay.
Oh, I don't know.
Time for question number 6. Let's go to work. Which U.S. state has more people per square mile overall than any other? New York, New Jersey, or Rhode Island?
New York?
What's it gonna be?
Use your
excellence. All right. Population density is a measurement of population per unit area. In other words, large population density means a lot of people live in a small area. The winner is New Jersey. Oh, that's right. A lot of y'all knew that. I'm proud of you. I would have thought for sure it's New York. Looking at apartments, everybody wants to give me a closet or like renting out a shower. I can't live in no shower. Come on now. 40,971 are having fun. Y'all know how it's done. It's time for question 7. What was the opening track on the U2 album that was given out for free to iTunes customers? Love Is All We Have Left, No Line on the Horizon, or The Miracle? Now remember, we got 2 more questions until the prize. The first prize. It's crazy. Okay. In 2014, Apple gave out a brand new U2 album for free, whether people wanted it or not. And a whole lot of people got riled up. Don't try to give me a homemade CD, U2. I don't want this. I actually liked it, though. The title of track one, parenthetical and all, was The Miracle of Joey Ramone. Woo-hoo-hoo! Savage question! Here it is! Savage question song! Sorry you got it wrong! Savage question song! That's a savage question song! Savage question! All right. Let's do it! Question number 8. Hope you're feeling great! The Strait of Gibraltar was long known by a Latin name that referenced what Roman god? Hercules, Neptune, or Jupiter? All right, the Latin name for the Strait of Gibraltar was Freedom Herculaneum. Yeah, because the 2 large spits at the eastern end were known as the Pillars of Hercules. The more you know! 10,716, got it? Oh boy! I'm proud of you. I'm so proud. All right. I'm about to ask you the first prize question of the night, okay? This is money time. I'm trying to figure out what I want to call it, okay? Money time. It's a money stop. It's a money flip. We're flipping the money right now. Okay, coming up. This is the first one. Ready? If you get this question right, you have a choice to take the money or keep moving forward to that $15,000 jackpot. Y'all ready? Good luck. Here is question 9. Mum was the name of the first trademark brand of what? Toothpaste, underarm deodorant, or lipstick? Can't use extra lives on these ones, babies. All right. Let's see what it's gonna be. Mum's the word, everybody. People have always had armpits, but it took until the late 1800s until people put out a mass-produced product to slap on in there. Enter Mum. Underarm deodorant. Woo! 6,600 people just got the first prize question. Y'all flipping the money, so I'm gonna flip it to you, okay? Here's the deal. I'm gonna offer all 6,600 of you 61 cents. You can take 61 cents and keep watching, or you can keep going for that $15,000. The choice is yours. What you want to do? Woo! That's right. Okay. 2,140 players chose to take 61 cents. That's crazy. The next prize is going to be in 3 questions. I'm so proud of y'all. Let's see. Maximus P, Satorius, Cindy in Miami, Al, Alex J 15, Shafe wonderful, yeah, Joel, whatever. Hootamaga. That was the little sound that the little tiki mask made in Crash Bandicoot. Question number 10. Oh, so proud of everybody. It was like, yeah, give me that money. I'll take the money. Let me get out of here. Question 10. Which part of the human spine allows for the greatest range of motion? Cervical, thoracic, or lumbar? What's it gonna be? When you talk about the spine, most of us do, most of our, you know, turning around the neck. And what part of the spine is that? You know it. It's the cervical spine. Yes, 1,699 got it. You can use extra lives again if you got them. But proud of y'all. That's the seventh question. Woo! Seventh question song. Sorry you got it wrong. Savage question song. That's a savage question song. All right, we got two more questions until the, one more. 11, and then the next, okay. All right, you can only use extra lives up until question 14. Don't forget it, okay? All right, here we go. Question 11. Which of these Belgian cities is not part of the Flemish Diamond? Brussels, Bruges, or Antwerp? The Flemish Diamond. Why is it called a diamond? Is it because a bunch of cities form kind of a diamond on the map? Yes, it is! The Flemish Diamond includes the cities of Brussels, Ghent, Antwerp, and Mechelen. Yeah. Bruges. That's outside the diamond, babies. Bruges was right. Yeah. 2,216 jelly beans are still on the scene with a gangster lean. And you are moving to the next money flip zone. Yeah? The money flip zone? I don't know. Question 12. I'm trying to give y'all some money. I'm trying to get you paid, okay? Let's go. Here we go. You get this right. You can't use an extra life on this, but you get it right. I'm gonna make you an offer. You probably shouldn't refuse. Okay, here we go. Who was the U.S. president when the furthest planet from the sun in our solar system was discovered? Thomas Jefferson, Theodore Roosevelt, or James K. Polk? Who's it gonna be? The planets have all been there for billions of years, right? But it took us a while to figure out they were out there. A big key was inventing the telescope, and Neptune was discovered in 1846. Did y'all know that? That's when James, my middle initial is K, Polk, was president. Woo! 1,732 just got it. So I'm about to give you a little money. You can take it if you want to. We're going to see what you're going to do. All right, check it out. I'm going to give you $1.16. You can take it. It's yours. Or you can stay and play for that $15,000. This is crazy. This is crazy. We changing the game. Okay, that's right. 242 players chose to take $1.16. Proud of y'all. Let's see who got it. Rock 898. Yeah. Kiri Lazo. Josek. And Vadam. Yeah. All right. I see y'all. I'm going to call y'all age quitters because you took the money and dipped. Okay. Question 13, babies. Here we go. Which of these cities became a U.S. state capital first? Topeka, Kansas, Salem, Oregon, or Charleston, South Carolina? Which of these cities became a U.S. state capital first? Topeka became the capital of Kansas in 1861, right? Salem became the capital of Oregon in 1859. Charleston is no longer the capital of South Carolina. That's Columbia. But it was the capital for 2 years before its statehood and 2 years after. 1786 to 90. What? Oh, yowza. Woo-hoo! Booba! Savage Question Song! Ah, dang, man. Savage Question Song. Sorry y'all got that wrong. But if you have an extra life, totally use it. Okay? We're playing. You decide you could have took the money. I bet you're feeling like you should have took that money now. Huh? Okay. All right. Here we go. Question 14. Which of these words did not originate as a name of a fictional character? Micawber, gargantuan, or silhouette.
What the? I have never.
Oh, boy. All right, just like the stage name of magician David Copperfield, the name Micawber comes from the Charles Dickens book David Copperfield. Gargantua was a character by Rabelais, but Silhouette, that was a real person. 457 of you are about to get another offer from me. It's the money flip zone. We're not calling it that. I'm going to think of something better. Here we go. Answer this question correctly. I'll make you an offer. You can take the money, you can stay and play, or walk away. Stay and play, or walk away. Yeah, that's fun to say. All right, here we go. More money, babies. I'm here for you. I'm trying to give you the money. So you can be a money flipper as well. Here we go. You can't use an extra life on this, by the way. Here we go. Which country includes 3 of the world's 10 largest islands? Japan, Canada, or Philippines? What's it gonna be? All right, it's another question about one of my absolute favorite countries, Canada. Ooh. Yes, 3 of the world's 10 largest islands belong to Canada. You got Baffin Island, Victoria Island, and Ellesmere Island. Yes, word. All 3 are their own province. Just kidding. Don't hate me, Canada. Woo! 444. Yeah. All right, let's see how much money I'm gonna give y'all right now. We're gonna see. We're gonna take a look. I know you're excited. You're sitting there excited. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. $13.52. Okay. You want to take it? What you want to do? Let me know. Tap it if you want to take it. If you want to stay and play, you feeling like you could get the 15 grand. Then we'll see. Oh, smart. Smart. Jenny, 1980. I see you, boo-boo. Yes, Randy Bird. Miss Kate King. Cameron. I'm so proud of y'all. Y'all took that. Y'all was like, oh, $13. What? Yeah, come on now. Let me get out of here. Stop the foolishness. All right, question 16, babies. Let's go. Which of these artists received an Album of the Year Grammy first? Bee Gees, Fleetwood Mac, or Billy Joel? Can't use any more extra lives. I was telling y'all, you can't use the extra lives past question 14, so now you in it to win it for real. But thankfully, we got another prize coming up. So you just gotta get through these. Okay, these 3 were back-to-back-to-back winners at the end of the 70s. But which one was first? Billy Joel got the Album of the Year Grammy in 1980, and the Bee Gees won in 1979, but Fleetwood Mac got it in 1978. Whoa! 134 are still in the game. Oh, boy. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Getting closer to the prize. Getting closer to the big prize. Close, so close to the big prize. Yeah. Jackpot, baby, is coming up. All right. Question 17. Here we go. Which of these countries is most likely to call the sport football instead of soccer? South Africa, Canada, or India? What's it gonna be? Alright, Brits love to make fun of the word soccer, but weirdly, tons of former British colonies prefer to call it soccer, including crowd favorite Canada, South Africa, and of course, the United States. India is the answer I was looking for, babies. 42! Woohoo! 42! Y'all knew what to do! Yeah! Alright. We got 42 players still in the game. I'm about to ask you another prize question. Another money flip station we have landed at. This is time to get the paper, okay? Make sure you tap carefully, all right? If somebody's talking to you, tell them to shut up unless they got the right answer. Pay attention, babies. Okay, here we go. Which of these animals has the slowest average running speed? Ostrich, pronghorn, or horse? Think about it. Use your animal knowledge. Which one of these animals has the slowest average running speed? Okay, because if you get this right, I'm going to throw some more money at you. And then you can tell me what you want to do. Yeah. All right. The pronghorn antelope hits speeds of nearly 61 miles an hour, right? While horses, a.k.a. the cars of yesterday, hit about 54 miles an hour. Ostriches are super fast for 2 legs, but they only hit about 43 and a half miles.
an hour. Get moving, ostriches. Come on now. Let's go. Woo! Oh! Woo! She wow! The slowest average run. 33 of y'all thought an ostrich was faster than a horse? We don't have cars riding around with ostrich power. What's going on? All right, there's two people that I'm making an offer to right now. Here we go. What's it gonna be? Oh, shoot. Dang. Oh, I like this. You want $2,500 right now? Or do you want to stay and play? I think if you don't take it, something wrong with you, okay? It's $2,500. Exactly. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, and his name is Maddie. Go ahead, Maddie Fied. You doing it, baby. Yeah. Do a backflip. And give me a life. You don't need one. You just got $2,500. Oh, yo. Y'all just did it. You won the game, babies. Yes. Woo, that was exciting. Congrats, H-Quizzes. Y'all did it. I'm sweating. This was very exciting. So much fun. I like this. I like this a lot. Yes, follow me on the socials at MattWasFunny. Don't go too far, all right? My girl Anna is coming up next at 9:30 with HQ Words. If you know how to spell, you know how to win, okay? I'm going to go and think of something else to call that prize moment. If you got an idea for it, hit me up, all right? Peace.